When it comes to the matter of meditation, let me confess that I don't do much meditation. I always feel that I should meditate, meaning the standard meditation wherein you sit straight, close your eyes and calm and, you know, focus on one thought. I wish that I also would do that, but you know, somehow when you sit in meditation, that time only there's a sweat drop coming, your nose starts itching, you start hearing the dog that is barking in the distance, you get irritated at your daughter playing in the background, you suddenly become more sensitive. What I feel meditation is it's about focusing on one thing at a time. That's what we do when we sit also, whether it's a Jyoti meditation or whether it is a meditation on one's breath, Soham. We focus on one thought. One reason why we have so much of disquiet in our life, why we lose peace in our life, is because there are hundreds of thoughts going on in our head. Even if our body is lying and we are sleeping, our mind is running. There are at least 1,000 thoughts at any point in time. To get genuine peace and relaxation, we have to be in a thoughtless state. Difficult to go thoughtless, that is the reason we are told to concentrate and contemplate on one thing. Because what happens is when I'm focusing on Swami, all other thoughts go and one thought is Swami, Swami, Swami. Yeah, maybe little other thoughts come, but even if I'm not able to focus only on Swami, from 1,000 thoughts, I've at least come down to 50 thoughts. The predominant thought being Swami, and there are other few thoughts, you know, that is there. But it has reduced from 1,000 to 50, that in itself gives us calm. Next time, maybe from 1,000, I can reduce it to 25. So therefore, I feel another way of meditation is if I'm not able to pull out separate time to meditate. It's like how Paramahamsa Yogananda was reprimanded by Yukteswar Giriji saying, what meditation are you doing? Same thing, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa hit Rani Rasmani on her head. She's a queen. He hit her and said, you are sitting here, but your mind is somewhere else. So I feel practical meditation would be, whatever I'm doing at that point in time, can I focus 100% on that? That's meditation. If it's my office work, can I refrain from going to Facebook or WhatsApp or doing something else? Some other website. If I am sitting and playing with my children at home, can I focus and give myself fully to my children rather than allowing a thought about my office? Oh, that is there, that is due this. We are constantly physically in one place, mentally in some other place. When we are sitting with children, we are thinking of office. When we are sitting in office, we are thinking about our children. We are doing the wrong thing everywhere. And therefore, I feel practical meditation would be, whatever I'm doing, at that point in time, focus all my energy and strength on that, my thoughts on that, my energy on that, and do that. And that would be one meditation after another, and we will see that our professional life, personal life, all life keeps improving.